Today we are reading If I Ran the Zoo by Dr. Seuss. If I Ran the Zoo. Mr. McGrew's Zoo. "It's pretty good zoo," said young Gerald McGrew, "and the fellow who runs it seems proud of it too. But if I ran the zoo," said young Gerald McGrew, "I would make a few changes. That's just what I do. The lions and the tigers and that kind of stuff they have up here now are not quite good enough. You see things like these in just any old zoo. They are awfully old-fashioned. I want something new. So I would open each cage. I would unlock every pen. Let the animals go and start over again. And somehow or other I think I could find some beast of much more unusual kind. A four-footed lion is not much of a beast. The one in my zoo will have 10 feet at least. 5 legs on the left and 5 more on the right. And then people will stare and they will say, 'What a sight. This zookeeper, new keeper Gerald's quite keen. That's a gold, darnest lion I have ever seen.' The new zoo, McGrew Zoo, will make people talk. My new zoo, McGrew Zoo, will make people gawk at the strangest thought creatures that did ever walk. I will get for my zoo a new sort of a hen who roosts in another hen's topknot, and then another one roasts in the topknot of his, and another in his, and another in his, and so forth, and onward and upward, gee whiz. But that's just a start. I will do better than that. They will see me next day in my zookeeper's hat, coming into my zoo with an elephant cat. They'll be so surprised, they'll all swallow with their gum. They will ask, when they see me, my strange animals come, 'Where do you suppose he gets things like that from? His animals all have such very odd faces. I will bet he must hunt them in rather odd places.' And that's what I will do," said young Gerald McGrew. "If you want to catch beast you don't see every day, you have to go to places quite out of your way. You have to go to places no others can get to. You have to get cold and you have to get wet too. Up past the North Pole, where the frozen winds squeal, I will go and I will hunt in my Skeagle Mobile and bring back a family of what do you know, and that's how my new zoo, McGrew Zoo, will grow. I will hunt in the mountains of Zomba Matant with helpers who will all wear their eyes at a slant, and capture a fine fluffy bird called Bustard, who only eats custard with a sauce made of mustard, and also a very fine beast called the Flustard, who only eats mustard with a sauce made of custard. I will catch them in caves and I will catch them in brooks. I will catch them in crannies. I will catch them in nooks that you don't read about in geography books. I will catch them in countries that no one can spell, like a country mota fa pota fa pel. In a country like that, if a hunter is clever, he will hunt up some bees that you never saw ever. I will load up 5 boats with a family of jotes, whose fair are like cows but wear squirrel skin coats, and sit down like dogs but have voices like goats, excepting they can't sing the very high notes. And then I will go to the wilds of Nantucket and capture a family of lungs in a bucket. Then people will say, 'Now I like that boy heaps. His new zoo, McGrew Zoo, is growing by leaps. He captures them wild and he captures them meek. He captures them slim and he captures them sleek. What do you suppose he will capture next week?' I will capture one tiny, I will capture one cute. I will capture a deer that no hunter would shoot. A deer that is so nice, he could sleep in your bed if it weren't for those horns that he has on his head. And speaking of horns that are just a bit queer, I will bring back a very old family of deer. A father, a mother, 2 sisters, a brother, whose horns are connected from one to the other. Whose horns are so mixed up, they can't tell them apart, can't tell where they end, and can't tell where they start. Each deer is mighty puzzled, is never yet found if his horns are hers or the other way round. I will capture them fat and I will capture them scurvy. I will capture a scroogle foot mullingani, a high stepping animal fast as wind from the blistering sands of the desert of Zin. This beast is the beast that the brave chieftains ride when they want to go far to find some place to hide. A mulligatwani is fine for my zoo, and so is a chieftain I will bring back one too. In the far western part of the southeast North Dakota lives a very fine animal called the iota, but I will capture one who is even much finer in the northeastern west part of South Carolina. When people see him, they will say, "Now by thunder, this zoo, new zoo, Negro zoo is really a wonder." Most beasts are quite friendly, but still in some lands, some beasts are too dangerous to catch with bare hands. For those that are ugly and vicious and mean, I will build a bad animal catching machine. It's rather expensive to build such a kit, but with it a hunter can never get bit. A zoo should have bugs, so I will capture a thrall whose legs are snarled up in a terrible snarl. And I will go out and I will capture some chugs, some keen shooter, mean shooter, bean shooter bugs. And I will go to the African island of Yerka and bring back a zizzle top tufted mazurka, a kind of canary with quite a tall throat. His lung is so long, his neck is so long if he swallows an oat. For breakfast the first day of April, they say, it has to go down such a long way, then it gets to his stomach the 15th of May. I will bag a big bug who is very surprising, a fellow who has the propeller for raising, and zooming around, making cross-country hops from Texas to Boston with only two stops. Now that sort of a thing for a bug is just tops. And when I have caught him, then the next thing you know, I will go and I will capture a wild tic-tac-toe. With X that's a win and with zeros that's a lose, he will look mighty good in a zoo of macaroons. I will bring back a gusset, a gherkin, a gasket, and also a gooch from the wilds of Nantasket. And 8 Persian princes will carry the basket. But what their names are, I don't know, so don't ask it. In a cave of Khartoum lives a beast called the Natch that no other hunter has been able to catch. He is hidden for years in his cave with a pout, and no one's been able to make him come out. But I'll coax him out with a wonderful meal that's cooked by my cooks in my cooker mobile. They'll fix up a dish that is just to his taste. 3 chicken croquettes made up of library paste, then sprinkled with peanut, shucks, pickled and spiced, then baked at 600 degrees and then iced. It's mighty hard cooking to cook up such feast, but that's how the new zoo, Megro Zoo, gets beasts. I'll go to the faraway mountain of Topsk, near the river of Nobsk, and I will bring back an Obsk, a sort of a kind Tingamabosk, who only eats rhubarb and corn on the cobs. Then people will flock to my zoo in a mobsk. Megro, they will say, does a wonderful jobsk. He hunts with such a whim and he hunts with such a vigor. His new zoo, Megro Zoo, gets bigger and bigger. And speaking of birds, there's a Russian Poluski, whose headski is redski and belly is pluski. I will get one of them for my zooski, Megroski. Then the whole town will gasp, why this boy never sleeps, no keeper before ever kept what he keeps. There is no telling what the young fellow will do, and then just to the show them I will sail to Kartu and bring back an itkach, a preep, and a proop, a nurkle, a nerd, and a seersucker too. I will hunt in the jungles of Hipponohungus and bring back a flock of Bipponabungus. The Bipponabungus from Hipponohungus are better than those down the Dipponadungus and smarter than those out in Hipponohungus, and that's why I will catch them in Hipponohungus. instead of those others in Nangus and Dungus, and people will say, when they see these pips bounding, this zookeeper, new keeper, simply astounding. He travels so far that you would think he would drop. When do you suppose this young fellow will stop? Stop? Well, I should, but I won't stop until I have captured the Fizza Man, Vizza Man Dill, the world's biggest bird from the island of Quok, who only eats pine trees and spits out the buck. And boy, when I get him back home to my park, the whole world will say, young McGrew made his mark. He's built a zoo better than the Noah's old ark. Those wonderful, marvelous beasts that he chooses have made him the greatest of all McGrewesses. Mr. McGrew's zoo, oh, they will all cheer. What this zoo must be worth. Is it the gold harness zoo on the face of the earth? Yes, that's what I would do, said the young Gerald McGrew. I would make a few changes if I ran the zoo. McGrew's zoo. This was a book, If I Ran the Zoo, by Dr. Zivitz.